pumpkin king.
Just talk really loud, I'm sorry.
Okay. The pumpkin king.
Okay. But anyway, I just wanted to get out of here and say that I'm back. Watching, nobody was interacting, which is okay. I know that now. But I wanted to do something where I felt like I was making progress somewhere. And so I decided to look for things online where I could make money. And I didn't make, I only made like $5. Earned $5 here and there. But that's because I worked at some sites for like 8 hours a day. I only got $5, but I didn't really work. I just earned from like survey sites and stuff like that. Yeah, it's not a job, but I realized that I don't really need a job currently at the moment. Because I'm not in a situation where I'm in dire need of it. But I'm occasionally wanting to do those sites, so I'm going to be doing ASMR on weekends. Because I want to earn money for more ASMR stuff, like tapping gloves. I'm going to get home hospital gloves. Gak, Nagoyan Gak, stuff like that. I'm gonna buy children's books that I used to like, and including one that I've never read before. It's called F is for Fart. And you know, it's a newer children's book, not from my era. But, yeah. I'm not even sure how this is gonna turn out. Because I'm behind a mask whispering. And usually that doesn't work out too well. I can always do a voiceover though, I guess. Maybe I'll do that if this doesn't pan out. Anyway, so yeah, I've been reading about this philosophy called non-duality. And it helped me see things that I'm not imprisoned in any means by, I felt pressured to get money because I felt like I was going nowhere in life and I felt like I needed to do something, But everything is perfect in this moment as is. We just need to relax. Every comment you get is a gift. Every smile you get is a gift. Just know, nothing's guaranteed, so we have to stop treating it like we're guaranteed all these things. That's the way I've been looking at life lately, just like everything is just great. When you really look at it from a really shorter perspective, no past, no future, just building into the future. Even though there is no future, it's just building into that concept of the future. But yeah, so that's what I've been studying lately. I've been writing a book about a guy who goes through a great deal of pain, but then he goes on a spiritual journey and realizes that everything is just really an illusion of the mind. How pain is pain if we just treat it as if it's just a feeling and nothing more. Truly, we will feel sad at times, we will feel angry, but if we just let it feel and accept it without fighting it, everything feels as it is, and it feels a lot better. I know that sounds crazy, and this book that I read is not meant to be understood. Let me tell you, this book is meant to be resonated with and felt. So basically, our reality is something where you can experience it with your ears. You can experience it with your touch, your sight, your smell. I don't have a sense of smell, so that's why that kind of left me. And yeah, basically, the mind separates. It's dual. Good and bad. And it kind of tends to lead us thinking about all the negative monks and the positive. Wanting us to be over here and putting us over here. And really, everything is as it is. But we don't see it that way. I just wanted to come on and talk about how I'm back and how I feel like a weight has been lifted off of me lately, just because I feel like nothing is as serious as I've always thought it to be, or nothing is as frustrating or, it's not as, it's not as important, but, you think, you put in effort for something, and then when something doesn't go your way, you're frustrated. But, really, you can't predict what's going to happen. Things just are the way they are. It's a gift that you've been given. Even if it's not the gift you want to give, it's still another day where you get to see things from a different perspective. But yeah. So, anyway, that's what I was going to talk about. Sorry, I kind of went off on a tangent with that. I plan on doing... I feel like I talked about this already. Yes, I have. About what my future videos are going to be about. That's another thing. I had a request from a friend who doesn't watch ASMR videos. to read a creepypasta video. They're narrating a creepypasta story for her while she goes to sleep. Right? Yeah, not while she goes to sleep, but you get what I'm saying. You guys watch ASMR when you go to sleep, so yeah. But yeah. So anyway, I'm back and I'm feeling good. I'm eventually gonna save up for a 3D. Sorry, I keep thinking different. Different thoughts at the exact same time. But, yeah, I'm saving up for 3DO, but I noticed that, the way I earn money on this one site, it would take 133 days for me to get a decent 3DO, which is like $600. So basically, right now I'm doing research and I'm reading books. I mean, I guess I could try looking at the library, but I'm buying these books. Well, I better buy them because I like to go back and refresh my memory and some of this stuff. But I'm reading books on non-duality through my book that I'm writing, and it's helping me a lot. So a lot of those books is where my money is going. Currently. So yeah, probably not gonna get 3DO for a long time. And that leads me to another topic, which a lot of you, I don't know how you're gonna take it, but I have a Patreon. What I do on my Patreon, I do ASMR videos, which I will start doing again, posting on there. And you guys will get early access to my videos if you join my Patreon. It's gonna be like $1 per month. I do short stories on there. And I will do this comic strip that I have. I actually have it on the, I'll link all the samples that I have. Free samples of my short stories and my my comics. Sorry, I was just kind of looking at that when I was talking. It looks like the mouth is moving, but it's just the way the mask is, I think. So really. I'm just gonna rant on for a few minutes just if I feel like it. But yeah, I gotta do a dark space for a while because I had some pain and all this other stuff happening to me. And I got into a huge depression where I just did not want to be anymore. And then I saw a video by I.E. Brown. I think that's her name on YouTube too. I'm not sure, but she's on Instagram as well. But she was talking about how everything is perfect as is. And, you know, it kind of made me feel a lot calmer the way she put it. The book I was reading was talking about how there is no you or me. The way I took it, you know, I'm still kind of trying to wrap my brain around the no you or me part. But the way I took it was that we are organic, biological machines. our hearts and minds operate, but most of what happens with the mind is illusion. And all that really exists and is our experience, things, touch, sounds, the senses, things all around us naturally. Nothing that we have been taught or the mind has created. So I don't know, that was kind of liberating that here. The book I was reading is by Jeff Foster. It's called An Extraordinary Absence, if you want to check that out. It's the weirdest book I have ever read, honestly. But I understood every freaking word. And you're not supposed to understand that, so he said that you're freaking insane if you understand it. Which, maybe I am, but at the same time, there are parts that were really out there for me, but they weren't supposed to be understood. So it made perfect sense, I guess, in a way that way. Because it was just intuitively understood. Which is kind of different than mentally understood. And this mask is starting to get hot, I think. If I do this mask, it'll have to be 20-minute videos. Because I don't know how much longer I can stay in this mask without wanting to take it off. Especially in a hot room, unless I'm outside. I'm also planning on getting a camera for mobility. Reasons. If I ever want to do an outdoor video, like, it'd be cool. I don't know if I'm going to be here next spring or fall or summer, but it'd be cool if you guys could see the place that I go to meditate. Before COVID, I don't go there now because everything's supposed to be closed to the public. Yeah. So anyway, I think that's all I'm gonna say. I will see you next time.